Our private reel tonight is on Quiet Riot. We joined the band at an autograph session in Worcester, Massachusetts. We spoke with lead singer Kevin Dubrow.
I think the kids that come to see Quiet Riot are the kids that are like Quiet Riot. They're rebellious. When I say kids, I'm not trying to say that we are teenagers, but we are the oldest juvenile delinquents on the earth today. I think they're rebellious, crazy people who want to go out, party, get crazy, and don't want to have anyone tell them you can't get wild, you can't make noise, and you can't bang your head. And that we relate to that, and they relate to us. And the participation part of our show is so important, and I think that's one of the reasons that we have our finger on the pulse of what American kids want today, because they're just like us, and we're just like them. Crazy. Mental health is the thumbprint of Quiet Riot in the sense that I think lyrically it speaks for what we're trying to get across to our audience. It says bang your heads, which I think is the new rebellious statement of the 80s, which is relating back indirectly to what the Beatles and Elvis Presley tried to say, which is we are the band parents love to hate and kids love to love, and it's time to have a party. And it's not time to be real intelligent with lyrics, it's just time to go out and have a good entertaining time. And that's what Quiet Riot tries to do. That's what mental health is all about, banging your head. The video, basically is, again, based upon the lyrics of the song, which is about a fan of Quiet Riot's going to one of our shows and getting so wild and out there that they throw him in an insane asylum for rock and rollers, demented rock and rollers, which is pretty much like the four of we are. And he escapes from this padded cell into the stage, which ends up being me out of the padded cell into the stage, just sort of a turnaround of the basic plot of the album cover, which is a fan who is in there like this in the straitjacket with all the buttons of each guy in the band because he's a fan. And he went so crazy at one of the shows from banging his head that they put him away. I think the impact of video depends upon the artist. From artist to artist, it differs. Certain artists, I think it is a help, and certain artists, I think it is everything. Their career depends upon video. With an act like ourselves, I think it's more of a help than anything else. Our videos, Mental Health and Come Feel the Noise, have both exposed Quiet Riot to people who otherwise would not have heard of them. With other groups, I mean, it sounds like I'm slagging everybody else but Quiet Riot, but with other groups, they don't have a particularly energetic live show that's worth paying any real money to go see, so they have to have a lot of cinematic effects and things going on around them to make it seem like the group is an entertaining group and put more into their music than is really there just on the vinyl or really where it really matters on stage. The 8 years it took to get to this point were all well worth it. And the fact that we constantly play live, which is really what we're all into it for, is because we love to get out there and every night, is what keeps us going. So, I mean, the 8 years are the 8 years. I mean, they're gone in history. And any bad things that happen or any good things are already done. And now is the important thing, because now is the only thing that really makes any difference. You have to learn from your mistakes, but you can't dwell on the past.